These are the games I really look for when I wake up in the morning and I know there's coverage that day. This is the type of match we are looking for. The
Definitely.
Best of the best.
Definitely, JC. Ano ba to? Preliminary ba to sa magiging finals ulit for this coming season? O hindi, pwedeng hindi, pwedeng oo. Pero alam naman natin, from the first conference to the second conference of last year, itong dalawang to lang palagi ang nakikita natin sa finals.
Well, wherever they are in the standings, we can always expect an exciting match between LaSalle and UST. We have more than the usual crowd in attendance, of course, to see the likes of Juan Butor Carpio, who is now donning the UST jersey. This will be her first season. Coach Ramil De Jesus has one championship belt under his name. Coach August Santamaria has the other championship trophy under his name. So each of these teams with a championship in the Shakey's V-League, and boy, do they deserve it. These are two of the best college teams in the country. Here we go. Point number one of set number one, and Rox Pimentel wastes no time at all getting to work.
And can you hear the crowd? First point palang. They're really into it.
Oh boy, this is just one of many, 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 many plays you will see from Roxy Pimentel. Side to Carolino. And off the blockers, Carolino scores. And one thing nice about LaSalle UST matches, umpisa pa lang, pataya na kaagad.
Parang gera, walang stop.
You know, the other team, no, not to take anything away from the other teams, but sometimes those matches, medyo mabagal sila mag-start, the players are still cold off the bench, but when LaSalle and UST meet each other, for some reason, boom, puto ka na kaagad from the get-go. And it's thanks to plays like that by Michelle Carolina. Watch, she saw it. To Carolina, does she love to set her up?
Again, off the blockers of UST, it seems that Michelle is going to that idea.
Okay, let's watch the LaSalle attack. Saw it to Maureen Penetrante. Oh, she touched the net. Yan ang mga rari na makikita mo sa game na to na marami at madalas. You can expect that when LaSalle plays UST. Carolino, sa kanyang gigil, napalakas ang tira and goes way out. And the fans say, go, UST.
And imagine, our score is only DLSU with 6 and UST with 5.
The game has just begun, folks. Malayo pa to. Side, sets up Legaspi. Ooh, great stuff. Good defense by UST, keeping the ball alive, and Legaspi goes wide. UST is making LaSalle commit their own errors. That's how they're scoring the points.
Alam mo, tama ka dun sa sinasabi.
Who's enjoying at the Rizal Coliseum? The fans are enjoying for free. Friends, dayo po kayo dito sa Rizal Memorial dahil libre ang entrada. You can watch your favorite players, your favorite college teams go at it for no admission price at all.
Funny yung group na yun, JC. Na-notice ko lahat sila. UST, go UST. May mga uniform pa. Tapos may isang girl doon na kawag. Go Michelle Carolina.
Out of place siya.
Mayroong isang girl.
I don't belong here. It's funny because the entire UST gallery, or at least the loud part of the UST gallery, is right behind the DLSU bench. Ooh! That will quiet them down. Of course, Balse, as we all know, is a 6-year veteran for Coach August, and she's on as a guest player. Wow,
good placement shot again coming from UST. Itong si Maureen, she really uses her height fully. Kung lahat ng pwede niyang gawin, gagawin niya. All around player din itong si Maureen.
On paper it says she's 5'11", but it seems like she's 6 feet
more than
tall.
That, yeah. Uh-huh. And when she plays, I'm sure more than 6 feet talaga, dahil mataas pang tumalo itong si Maureen. And truly, maaasahan kong si Maureen, lalo na in front of the net.
Butor Carpio, who does she set up? Pimentel. You saw the power of that Pimentel shot.
Oh, but now she's called for a net violation.
Oh, boy.
So it was Saet who committed that error. Ito rin, kailangan pakuntian ng error dito sa dalawang teams na to.
It's close, 13-14. Saet goes to Maureen. And Maureen makes it look so easy. Anne Mulia is sitting by the bench of her former team, reminiscing. She has this report.
Xavier, well, kanina, no, during the timeout, narinig ko kila Coach August, binibigyan niya ng instructions yung team nila. And it seems that they're adjusting pretty well because alam nyo ba na itong si Joan Botor, she's playing as the libero of the national team. Pero dito sa Shakey's B-League, setter siya. Pero as we can see, no, maganda naman yung adjustment ng USP.
Wow, how hard is that, Mosey?
That's
you practice,
very
you practice
difficult.
With one team on a different position and you practice with your other team later on in the day, iba na naman position mo. Coming back after LaSalle practically led the entire first set but only by a small margin, and now UST can grab the lead again. Do they? Look at those one-hand dutches.
Yung mga saves ng UST is keeping them in the set.
Just quick reactions from the players. Ila Santos, does she get over? Yes. Motor Carpio. Libero turns setter, goes to Balse. Dagapay sa Legaspi. Look at the quick reactions by UST. On the ball. Everyone's eyes are on the ball. Oh! Bernal could not get to that one. And Ila Santos sends her flying flat on the ground.
Ang hirap bigyan ng free ball nitong dalawang teams na to. Nakita nyo naman, every time attack.
You sure papatayin yan talaga.
Oh, double violation is being given to Desiree Hernandez. So now again, we're deadlocked at 20.
Not to mention, she is one of the crowd favorites. Another crowd favorite is Roxy Pimentel, but she was stopped there. And Santos again!
And again! Manila Santos delivers for LaSalle.
Ila Santos. LaSalle is 3 points away from closing out the first set. But UST is 4 points away from closing out the first set.
Alam mo, nakita ko si Anna sa huddle, ah. Gustong makipag...
Nakiki-fight-fight siya doon.
Oo, oh, eh. Namimiss talaga, nagre-reminisce.
Let's get that jersey out of her bag and make her play. Chisayet. Ooh, penetrante! That is what national team players are made of.
So now it's a two-point lead for De La Salle. Let's see what UST will do to stop this rally by LaSalle and end this set.
23-21, Hernandez to serve. Dug up by Koyukang, not the reception they wanted, but they get a lucky break there. The running Pimentel! That's what the fans were looking for.
Ito another labanan ng smart setters tong game na to. Because as you can see, a point is needed at this stage of the game sa USD. They go to Pimentel. Kanina hindi naman, di ba? At kanina naman si Chisa, eh, nakita niya si Manila yung gumagawa, kaya Manila niya binibigay. So makikita mo, ang mga setters rin will play a very important role in this game.
That time, Chisa setting it to Penetrante with a smart play, scoring off the blockers, just dipped it, and now we are at set point for DLSU. Mind you, DLSU has not yet lost a set this entire season. Just some trivia for you guys to digest. Saed sets up Maureen. Oh! And the record continues. DLSU still unbeaten, literally, this season. Not a game lost, not a set lost. And it's because of plays like that. Veteran moves by Carolino and Penetrante and Chi side as well. This is our shaky, shaken play. Watch Chi with the back set to Michelle. Wham! Kills it. LaSalle 1, UST 0. We'll be back after this short commercial. The Ateneo players are enjoying the action. After their win earlier today, they are here to stay on to watch the UST LaSalle match, just like many of the fans that have arrived dito sa ating Rizal Coliseum. At talaga naman pag LaSalle versus UST, dumadami, tumitriple.
Imagine
ang
mo naman
mga yun. Attendance.
Naglaro na kanina yung team na yun, and yet they stayed to watch this game. Ganyan po ka-exciting ang mga games dito sa Shakey's B-League. That's why we continuously invite you to come over and watch the games live and for free.
And who wouldn't want to see points like that live? Mary Jean Balse starting the second set the way Rox Pimentel started the first set. Instantly killing the ball for UST and getting the first point. But can UST keep doing that to give LaSalle their first loss of a set this season? Bernal, she's stopped by the blockers. Carpio, Ubalse, She's tied. She will go to Carolino and check ball. Yes, they get what they were asking for. 2-1 all. The score is deadlocked. Like many times it will be in this set. Pwede mo na bilangin yung mga deadlock mo, partner.
Oo nga. Okay.
1-1 is the count, Koyu Kang.
Poor reception from Kay Koyu Kang. May kita mo, itong si Penetrante had a 60% attack success rate as against the 28% only of Roxy.
Wow.
Roxante Mentel.
Napakalaking discrepancy niyan.
Yeah, yes, and ito pa ha, ang errors ng UST was 11 in that set. Ang laki nun for, I mean, a high caliber team like UST. 11 errors. So, kung imagine mo, 11 points yun eh.
That is what hurt them. We have not seen the Roxanne Pimentel that we are used to in this game
so
far.
Yung dominance niya is still missing. So, let's see if it will come in this set.
Alam mo naman itong volleyball. It happens also in spurts. The players suddenly heat up. Escarpio. Does she go over? Too much over. Carpio again. Pimentel now. Hits it over. Lasal goes to Carolino. Does she kill it? Ooh! That's how strong Michelle Carolino can spike.
At nagkagulo sa defense that time si Venus Bernal and si Mary Jane Balse.
Pag ganito, sino dapat kukuha ng bola? Ooh!
Pareho silang hindi libero in that sense. So, ako mas ma-appreciate ko na nagkagawan sila kesa nagtinginan sila.
That's right. Kate hits the antenna, tries with the left hand violation. Alam mo itong dulaw ng schools na to, sa lahat ng sports talaga may rivalry sila. Sa football, sa basketball.
Ibig sabihin, both of these schools has good sports programs in their schools, no? Respective schools.
Two of the best sports programs in the country. Pero itong dalawa, talaga sa UAP, nakikita itong dalawang to. What is UST doing? They can't seem to get the attack they want.
Because of poor reception, okay, there again, another poor reception on the UST side. Parang ang gulo nung kanilang
yes.
defense rotation, nagkakagulo sila sa loob. Hindi nila masabi precisely kung kanino yung bola dapat na yon.
Whereas on the other hand, LaSalle working like a well-oiled machine. Everybody knows their place in the rotation, everybody doing their job, moving their feet, hustling. And that is why they are up 10-5.
Ayan, even in setting, nagkakaroon na errors itong UST.
Si Ann nakinig sa timeout ng UST. Ann, what seems to be the problem?
Actually, no, it's the same thing. Coach August is reminding his players of the same thing. Bakit daw sila dumedepensa ng nakatayo? He wants them to defend in the right position. Bumaba naman daw sila. At nagugulat-gulat daw sila sa mga play nitong LaSalle, which I can see naman na LaSalle is really delivering well. Pero if only UST plays more aggressively and minimizes their errors, mapapantayan nila ang pinapakita ng laro ng LaSalle.
Well, excellent point. Well, we'll see if that's exactly what they can do.
Anak ba ako ni August? So, hindi. Parang exacto.
Of course, Moji Ravena, many years playing under Coach August Santa Maria. So, alam mo na siguro yung mga pinagsasabi niya just through his body language.
Pero that's so true because kanina ko pa napapansin, nakatayo sila sa depensa. Wala kang makukuha ng depensa kung LaSalle lang kalaban mo at ganon ang position mo sa depensa. Dapat yan, lahat kayo nakababa at lahat ng bola, yours. Mine pala, hindi nga dapat yours, lahat mine.
Bye.
Kung pwedeng ikaw lahat kumuha because you don't have a libero inside. So let's see if they can string up some more points to catch up with the DLSU at 14. UST is now at 10.
Mary Jean serving. Dug up by Hernandez, not the good reception they'd expect. So it's UST's turn to capitalize on these poor receptions by DLSU, but the blocking is phenomenal. Penetrante and Carolina totally denying Torrijos. Torrijos' shot did not stand a chance. Watch this block.
But a brave effort though by Torrijos, knowing that these two were in front of her, still went for that attack.
Carpio sets up Torrijos again. Watch them give Torrijos the ball to sort of boost her confidence again. That's what a good teammate does. They help each other out.
Otherwise, it's either regalo or mapupunta lang sa net. Hindi mo na masisave.
She does a better job this time on the set. And wow, how about that dig? Keeping the ball alive. Sayang naman. Venus Bernal gave all her power in that shot. As in, talagang linabas niya lahat. Pero
makikita mo, Lasal was able to dig that pa rin. So, Lasal is playing great at this point.
17-11, Lasal leads. She side to Carolino with the dink. Bernal gets it. Coyucang dinks it. Wala. Legazpi. This time she tries Hernandez, who goes wide. So, little by little, UST climbing up the scoreboard.
Alam mo, itong UST also, no? Yung mga decisions nila in their blocking. Kasi kanina, since time and again, nakikita natin, out na sana, natatouch lang nilang pakunti-kunti yung ball eh. So, yung decisions nila dun sa blocking will be integral in this game.
Well, how about their decision to block that time? Roxy Pimentel and Coyucang teaming up on the double block. At ang ganda naman ng stuff na to. Watch the UST defense. Wow!
Attack yung pagkakabalik.
Oh. 17-13, LaSalle's lead is only down to 4. UST still very much in this game. We're seeing better coverage now from UST. And there's Coyucang. Good reaction by Hernandez to keep the ball alive. Carolino!
Michelle Carolino just drilling that one in!
Unfazed! You know, Carolino got stuffed on the earlier play, but watch right here. Talagang the killer instinct of Michelle Carolino, and the block was late.
Papansin mo, JC, ilang points na rin na nagagawa ni Manila Santos dun sa cross-court shot niya na yun. Hindi pa rin nakaka-adjust itong UST, so medyo matagal ang adjustments na nangyayari.
Here's Pimentel. Dug up by the good floor coverage of DLSU. Nice tip by Hernandez. Oh, good presence of mind. Ball is still alive. Now Ila tries to kill it. Oh, Venus Bernal was late. She hesitated.
Yes.
She hesitated. 21-14 is the LaSalle lead. They are up one set to none. UST needs this set more than DLSU, but the way the game is being played, parang LaSalle ang humahabol. Oh!
Oo nga, nakala ko pa naman inside yun.
It was the closest
of
9 balls.
Oh, such a close call.
And watch the sloppy UST play. John Botor Carpio barely getting that ball in. And look. Look at Ila Santos kill it. Let me remind everyone again watching that LaSalle has not yet lost a set this entire season. And at 24-15, it looks like, well now 24-16, they are in a good position to keep that record intact. The ace by Kate breathed a little life into UST. But they are not allowed to commit any more errors in this set because LaSalle is already at 24. Lead to Ila Santos. She goes long. So a mini rally by UST keeping their hopes alive dito sa ating second set.
So they have to play perfectly six straight points. Or is it seven, ano?
Mm-hmm.
To take this set.
We'll see. That's six set points for LaSalle. Let's see if they get it. Carpio barely making it over. Now Lee will set up Maureen. Dug up by Coyucang. Can they chase it down? No, they cannot. And the untainted set record of LaSalle stays intact. They have successfully completed two sets in this match unfazed by UST. This is our shaky shake and play. Let's watch the DLSU attackers. Chi Sayet sets up Ila Santos through the double blockers. And that will give LaSalle set number two. We'll be back after the short commercial break. Sige nga, Mosey, ano ang mga benefits na makukuha mo?
Ating
manood?
Lahat.
Favorite natin lahat ang shake.
At si Ann may sinasabi.
I think Ann wants pizza also. Bakit Ann?
Yeah, I want pizza also. No, a while ago, no, I went to the bench of UST and actually, no, both coaches know that they're up against strong blockers and spikers. So strength alone won't earn them a point. Kailangan may presence of mind din. And up to this point, reception pa rin ang pinapaalala ni Coach August sa mga players niya dahil hindi sila makaset up ng magagandang plays dahil wala silang receive.
And that is exactly why they are down two sets to none.
Akala ko sabihin niya, hanggang ngayon, pinapaalala pa rin ni Coach yung presence of mind. Wala.
Medyo kailangan talaga. Oh! Beautiful tip. Beautiful tip. You know what? UST has gotten all the first points of each set in this match. They start out well,
with nice spectacular points like this one, the running Bernal tip, but they can't seem to sustain it. Dagupay Peñano, she saw it, will set up Michelle Carolino, and she makes it look easy.
Alam mo, even at this point in time, si Michelle Carolino has not really attacked so many in hits, ano? Yung hindi naman ganun kadami, and yet, nakuha ng Lasal ng 2 sets. It's either USC is really, really playing badly, or nag-step up itong mga other teammates ni Michelle.
Well, we'll see how it turns out in this set. Pimentel tips it over. Carolina stretches to get it, and one tip after another. Good defensive job by both teams to keep the ball alive. The rally is on side. It goes to Legazpi this time. Dug up by Vida Gutierrez. From the back line, Mary Jean bouncing. And Chi Saet will bring her team to 3. USD is still at 1. Third set action. La Salle has won 14 straight sets this season. Check ball. Yes, USD gets it. Not with a spike, but with the softest of touches. Gets it down in front of the block. 4-2, La Salle leads. Legazpi sets up Carolino. One guest player to another. Botor to Bernal.
Off the block.
She goes. Peñano bumps it up. Saet to Hernandez. Now USD can set up properly. They go to Vida Gutierrez. Ooh, she is blocked. Good effort by the defense. Hustle to get the ball over. Saet now goes to Carolino. This will be strong. But Koyugang says, no problem. Here's Venus running again and gets... Oh, not quite.
Good save by Desiree Hernandez.
Good presence of mind by Hernandez to keep the ball alive. And Bernal for the third time will attack. But again, dug up by Carolino. Bernal cannot buy a point. Here's Balte trying. How about the floor coverage of PLSU? Hindi makalusot ang Lasal. And they show them how to kill the ball.
Oh, wala boy. Akong masabi doon sa atake ni Michelle Carolino.
You see, ilang attempts ng USD.
Appreciate this. Oh,
beautiful, beautiful.
Beautiful, beautiful play coming from DLSU.
Grabe naman. Ilang atake ng USD, pinigil ng Lasal, and finally they showed them how to do it. Whoa!
And good save by Michelle Carolino.
Sobrang swerte naman nila kung pumasok yun. There you go. That's how to work it. That's how you do it. Botor to Balse. Yun ang hinahanap natin kanina pa from USD. The one-handed set. Look at that. Ang ganda. La Salle playing an overall great game led by the efforts of Ila Santos and Maureen Penetrante. Michelle Carolino as well. Overall, excellent attacking from the Lady Archers. They are up 2-0. And in this set, are up 8-5. We have some statistics from our sets so far.
Of course, it has been a Carolina show for the De La Salle. She has a total of 11 attacks with 8 attack points. While on the side of USC, it has been Venus Bernal carrying the load with 6 attack points.
9-6 La Salle. Ila Santos, good serve. Dagupay Balse, oh, not the best of receptions. Again, we go back to Coach August's comment about, wow, when you do not receive the ball well, you give your opponent the opportunity to kill shots like that.
Tapos just enough power, still hindi pa rin nakukuha nitong USD.
This is not the USD team that we saw win the first championship. Will they show up? Look at the effort by La Salle. Look at the, they are up 2-0, but they're diving for that ball as if they were fighting for their lives.
Well, you said it, JC. That's why they're up.
5'11" or 6 with shoes. Oh.
Nagpahila ako sa dalawang kotse.
Gumana ba?
Hindi.
Next time, subukan mo truck. Legazpi gets it down from the blockers, but good reflexes by Bernal to get the ball back up in. Saito Carolino, will she kill it? No, says Koyukang. Here's Bernal again. Oh, stuff is Bernal. Where was her coverage? Koyukang was,
you know,
not there.
That was so stuffed, JC.
Oh, super
ang
stuffed.
Ang lapit na yun sa... Mapapansin nyo, malapit na sa line yung block na yun eh. But in spite of that, yung angle ng kanilang pagkaka-block, pumasok pa rin.
Wow, Maureen Penetrante did not win blocker all those years in the UAP for nothing. Here's Bernal. She'll get another try, but still she is blocked twice in a row. Penetrante and Legazpi denying Venus Bernal.
Alam natin, mahusay talaga mag-service tong si Chi.
Kaya makikita man si Coach Ramil, no reaction. Okay lang yan.
Bihira lang naman.
Yes.
Bihira lang naman mangyari. Penetrante. Dagapay Balse. Pimentel gets it over. Nice. By Pimentel rather. Quick thinking. Saw where the defense was. Put the ball in the right place. So still, we have to hear more from Pimentel. She is the offensive leader of this team, as proven in the past.
Oh,
Bernal, regalo. Regalo kay Bernal. She says thank you. And UST now at 11. So pwede pa.
Oh, yes. Very possible.
17 to 11 is the count. LaSalle will attack courtesy of Legazpi. At the net, who wins? Oh, two touches.
But good effort though by Con Legazpi. Makikita mo rin yung focus niya because she was still trying to get that ball in play kahit anong part na ng body niya eh.
Of course, like we said time and again, any part of your body will work. But that time, all Carolina needed was her wrist. Pangalawang beses na niya i-deny si Bernal. And here's Palse. Will she be denied? Wow, Carolina picks that up. Ila Santos. It's outside. Venus Bernal will serve. They are down by 4, 16-20. Carolino pops it up. Legazpi, the bump set to Ila Santos. She gets it over. Pimentel is there waiting. Here's Balse with a quicker. Ila Santos digs it up. Saed, quick to the set. Futor Carpio to Balse.
Balse! They have been missing that hit from Balse since the first set.
And finally, Mary Jean Balse, the former MVP, shows up and does what she is supposed to do for her team, and that is to lead and kill UST, only down by 3. So UST with a good run here in the middle of the third set. They are down 2-0. She side goes to the left side to Legazpi. She's blocked. Side to Legazpi again. Oh! Great move by Legazpi to confuse the defense. Here's side. Who does she go to this time? Back set to Legazpi! I hate to say this term, and I hope you don't take offense because I know you're from UST. But parang pinaglalaruan ng offense ng LaSalle ang defense ng UST. Almost. Ooh! Well, that time, mukhang narinig ako ni John Butor Carpio.
Yan ang sinasabi natin, ano, kahit naman sa ang teams, nangyayari to, na really, reception muna. Ang defense talaga, yan, it's very important in volleyball because yung reception mo starts everything.
Yes. And that's what LaSalle has been doing so well. Look at Chisa.
Like just here. See?
Her options are limitless. Now she goes to Ila. Oh, kuyuk lang.
It's just wala. The reception of USD killing them.
We are at match point. LaSalle has won 14 sets in a row this season. They want to win their 15th set in a row and get win number 5. Will they do it on this point? Penetrante says, oh, it's out. Whew. Everybody holding their breath on that point.
So now UST is at 20 and LaSalle is at 24. Let's see.
You know, this is not yet over. That's only 4 points. UST can still tie this up. Koyukang. Dug up by LaSalle. They go to their sure player, Michelle Carolino. And so fittingly, she ends it for the Lady Archers. So it is official. 15 straight sets for DLSU. They are 5-0 and undefeated in every way you look at it. Set-wise, game-wise, DLSU has lorded it over so far in the first half of our Shakey's V-League First Conference. Congratulations, Mr. Philip Wico, Coach Ramil De Jesus, and the rest of the girls, Maureen, Chi, Michelle.
And they just played a great game.
Super game.
And they dominated USC. And siguro itong USC just had a bad day. As we see our shaken play.
Just one of many of the kills of Michelle Carolino. And that was the point that ended the match. We'll be back to wrap things up. Please stay with us.